Earthquakes strike all over the world, and once they're over a certain threshold, they become big news. But what do those numbers they tell you on TV really mean? Hey everyone, thank you for watching DNews today. I'm Trace. Nepal was recently hit by a 7.3 on the Richter scale, less than 3 weeks after being hit by a 7.8. The 7.8 destroyed buildings, killed thousands, and caused an avalanche. The 7.3 caused a panic and killed only a few dozen. Does 0.5 on the scale make that big a difference? Firstly, let me step back for a bit. When you describe a great dessert to a friend, you probably give it a rating. We humans love to rate things, but to truly rate it fairly, you'd have to understand the ingredients and the preparation, the plating, and the ideal dessert comparison, what you've just eaten prior, what you're drinking, where you're sitting, the temperature of the room you're in, even your mood at the time. Not to mention, you know, whether you had a fight with your friend earlier that day, because that's going to all affect your rating. Science needs history, context, and tons of points of data, and that's just for a piece of cake. How can you turn all that data into one simple rating? Most people don't. They just measure how they feel about it at this moment. Like a layer cake, earthquakes are all different. When rocks are sliding, knocking, and buffeting against one another, they can slip, crack, jerk, and cause an earthquake. But the friction and the fault line, the pressure, the depth, the type of rock, and the varied stressors of that rock's history all matter. To turn that into one number is actually a pretty crazy idea if you think about it. So the Richter scale was invented in the 1930s to give some understanding to the magnitude of a quake as measured by seismographs, ground monitoring equipment that's often used in earthquake measurement. It's logarithmic, so every 1 point on the scale is a tenfold increase. So a 3 to a 4 on the Richter scale is tenfold more powerful, and 3 to a 5 is 100-fold. Or to put it another way, a 7 is 10,000 times more powerful than a 3 on the Richter scale. The US Geological Survey says that there are 1.4 million quakes that register above 2 every year, and only 16 that get a 7 or higher. But even after I've explained it to you, do you actually know what the Richter scale means? What does that number mean? Because I don't know. The Richter scale is only concerned about the amount of energy released by that single quake and doesn't tell us much about what that quake did. Maybe it was a deep quake or away from a populated area. Maybe the quake was under soft ground or in the middle of firm bedrock. All of that would change how that earthquake was experienced or how humans feel it. The Mercalli scale, or modified Mercalli scale, measures intensity of earthquakes. This is also used by the US Geological Survey to understand how the earthquake felt on the surface. The Mercalli scale was also developed in the 1930s, and it uses Roman numerals to determine how intense a quake is. They range from 1 to 12. It's subjective. So, for example, a 2 is weak and, quote, felt only by a few persons at rest, especially on upper floors of buildings. But a 6 is strong and, quote, felt by all. Many are frightened. Some heavy furniture is moved. A few instances of fallen plaster. Damage is slight. This is a measure of how it feels in an earthquake. It adds more data to what happened during that quake, moving us closer to understanding what really happened. There's also the moment magnitude scale, which is a new measure for quakes. Moment magnitude allows scientists to use computer models to create synthetic seismograms and determine exactly how the quake released energy through its magnitude. Essentially, how far a fault moved and the force required to move it. It gets seismologists really excited because it's way more accurate than the antiquated Richter measurements, and it works all over the world as a standard measure. And it can go above magnitude 8, or M8, which Richter cannot accurately. Okay, so now that you know the basics, according to the Incorporated Research Institutions for Seismology, the April 25th earthquake in Nepal was an M7.8 with an MMI ranging from 4 to 9. Most of the reports were in 5 to 6. So it felt strong, the ground moved, and for some people, it was considered severe and violent. This complicated cocktail of factors have to be considered to help determine how earthquakes are experienced and categorized. Just like anything, though, we can always learn more. If you're curious about how earthquakes even happen at all, Julia did a great video about the science of earthquakes over here.
Now scientists know that the Earth is made up of several layers. The mantle and the crust make out the outermost shell, the lithosphere. This crust is broken up into 7 or 8 major tectonic plates, which float on top of another layer called the asthenosphere.
Have you ever been in an earthquake? What was it like? Tell me about your experiences in the comments, or you can come over to Twitter or Facebook and let us know there. We're at DNews or at Discovery News.